Mallet Sports Center in Lausanne, Switzerland. Welcome to the 1997 World Figure Skating Championships presented by MasterCard. Here are the standings after the pair short program. Mandy Wurzel and Ingo Steuer of Germany lead Eltsova and Bushkov of Russia. Down in fifth place, the newly crowned American champions, Kyoko Ina and Jason Dungeon. They'll be first on the ice in this free program that will account for two-thirds of their final score. Bob Varsha, along with Olympic silver medalist Peter Carruthers with you. The music, Grand Canyon Suite.
Kyoko and Jason are very strong with the amount of speed that they have across the ice, and they will unload some very difficult pair elements. Here, the first one, a throw triple Salchow. Right away, stepping up into side-by-side triple toe loops, right on. This team is a good match because there is enough of a size difference between Kyoko and Jason that they can be very acrobatic.
After three consecutive years finishing as runners-up to Jenny Mino and Todd Sand. Oh, problems for Jason.
Yes, he flipped out on the landing, but a little distraction, not a major disruption at this point.
As I was saying, after 3 years as runners-up to Mino and Sand at the U.S. National Championship, this was a breakthrough year for Kyoko and Jason, and it came under very difficult circumstances. Their coach, Peter Burrows, lost his wife 2 weeks before the National Championships to cancer. Yet they managed to come through and win.
Typically in a pair program like this one, the slow music is used as sort of a place to rest a little bit, slow the pace down, show some style and expression, and get ready for the big sprint at the end of the program. Split triple twist lift, a bit of a collision on the landing, but watch this right here, throw triple loop. Very powerful elements. This is when the legs are on fire. You're starting to fatigue, but if you're trained, you're able to skate through this section and hopefully have as much power as you did in the beginning of the program. And they don't look like they're dropping off at all. Beautiful variation on the lasso lift. It's difficult because of the change in position throughout that lift. All the difficult elements out of the way. You can hear the coach, Peter Burrow, screaming, yeah. Oh, beautiful program, and what an ending. Dramatic. They've really grown as pair skaters. They're showing a lot more presentation in their skating, and Bob, incredible elements to match. Difficult with lots of hard throws, lifts.
3 years ago in this competition, they finished 12th. 2 years ago, they were 8th. Last year, they were 6th. This year, they hope to move up.
And they have good coverage across the ice on this lift. And what I mean by that is the speed in which they travel across the ice is strong, showing good control on the lifts. Here's where the problem was. Watch Jason. He'll flip forward on the landing. He wanted to stay backwards the way she did for a clean exit on that jump.
Now here are their scores.
The technical merit scores should be pretty good for these two because they had just that, a lot of technical merit in the program. So far you can see 5-5 up to 5-7, and it will stay that way across the board. Presentation scores, 5-6, 5-5. Not too bad. They turned in a strong performance, and they've really come up in their presentation this year. And we're seeing that in these presentation scores. Good job.
We'll be back to Switzerland in a moment. ESPN coverage of the greatest annual championship in worldwide figure skating. Tonight we have the pairs and ice dancing competitions for you, and with me once again to bring them to you, ESPN experts Judy Blumberg and Peter Carruthers. Peter, we'll start with the pairs. We've just seen Kyoko Ina and Jason Dungeon skate. It's nice that America's other great pair, Jenny Mino and Todd Sand, have some company in the upper echelon.
Well, it is to see American teams in fourth and fifth place after the short program. However, right now, Mino and Sand have some ground to make up. They've got to skate well in order to get into the medals. Now, pair skating, as we all know, has been a Russian-dominated sport. However, in first place, Virchel and Steuer from Germany are the leaders right now, and they've been very consistent this season. Eltsova and Bushkov, who are in second, defending world champions, need to turn in a strong performance, better than strong, in order to win this championship. But look for the team of Kazakova and Dmitriev. They're in sixth place right now, but they have the ability to really turn on their performance and create electricity when they skate. They're very exciting, but this competition is wide open.
Now, later on, we'll move to ice dancing. And, Judy, it's no surprise to see the world and Olympic champions Grichuk and Platov right up top.
That's right. They are on top yet again. They have unique style. They are very dramatic. However, this time they're skating under less than ideal circumstances. They have recently changed coaches. They are not in the best favor with their association. And Evgeny has a knee injury, and he will be having surgery after this competition.
Now back on the ice, ready for our next pair. From Canada, Christy Sargent and Chris Wirtz.
Last year's World Championships, they were seventh.
Their music is a medley from soundtracks to the movies The Mission and Waterworld.
Split triple twist lift. Well done. Difficult side-by-side triple toe loops. And she goes down. When you see that happen, it's usually through your peripheral vision. And it is a distraction. But you just have to keep going and hope that your partner can get up and get back on the same foot as you for the next steps that follow. Throw triple Saukow. Ooh, a little high in the air. She lurched forward because he may have thrown her a little bit too high. You have to assist on a throw, not actually throw the girl.
Mm-hmm. pair has been together for about 5 years now. When they first came together, Christy was skating singles. She was also a single mother of a young daughter. Now all three live together.
Side by side, double axles, followed up by double toe loops. Double axle. The arms kind of waving in the air, showing that she was off balance. She had to really fight for that. Very difficult music to interpret because you've got to be right on. There's a lot of silence in this music. As I said, difficult to interpret because it's so quiet. Some breaks in position on some of the lifts that could be a little bit more perfected on the floor before they get on the ice.
We'll be back to Switzerland in a moment.
Classic.
5-3, 5-3, 5-4. The technical merit marks show the lifts, the spins, the throws, the jumps that were performed in the performance all the way down to 5.1. They know that they didn't bring the performance level up to that of which they could have at the World Championships. Here the presentation, well, they're all very consistent.
Our next pair on the ice, Oksana Kazakova and Artur Dmitriev. Fifth in this competition a year ago and sixth this year after the short program.
Oksana Kazakova has really brought her level up. As a female pair skater, she's exceptional now on the very difficult throws and lifts that are demanded of her in this world competition.
The music by Hendel Pasakwala.
You know, it really is unbelievable. Just over a year ago, they started skating together, and she really didn't look like a world-class pair skater. Now, she certainly does. They'll need these. They're the side-by-side triple toe loops. They'll set the pace. She did hers. Artur only did a double. Unusual, it's usually him that hits it. Side by side double axles, double toe loops, fine.
Dmitriev, a former Olympic champion and two-time world champion with his former partner, Natalia Mishkutinok.
This is where she has improved. Look at the height on that throw triple salchow and the sureness of the edge on the landing. Not a difficult overhead lift, but what you did see was an exquisite position at the top of that lift. Here, the throw triple toe loop, most impressive.
Perhaps their most amazing accomplishment was that with just a few months together, they went out and won the European Championships in 1996, their very first attempt together.
And I can guarantee you, the focus that they have with their coach, Tamara Masvina, is very intense.
This is an incredible move. With control.
It's a trick. And every program has a place for a good trick.
Oh, they're so unusual and very inventive.
They're important skaters, and their performances add up to a very strong emotion, and it makes us almost have a great tendency to forgive their mistakes.
Kazakova and Dmitriev of Russia in sixth, looking to move up. The crowd loves it. And when we come back, the reigning world champions will take the ice. Yeltsova and Gushkov in second place, trying to move up to first in a moment. Kazakova and Dmitriev, along with their coach, Tamara Masvina, after a program dick in which there was a mistake early on.
Well, it wasn't really a mistake. It was just a failure to do for him to do a triple toe loop when she did one. So that was a slight lessening of score. Not really a disastrous mistake. I'm forgiving them because I think they're wonderful.
Because I know you love
and
this.
And I have great passion because they have great passion for skating. And that's what they're all about.
The technical merit marks reflecting that double instead of the triple. And then the presentation marks 5.5 up to 5.8 for Kazakova and Dmitriev of Russia. And here is the pair getting ready to skate. They're in second place, Marina Yeltsova and Andrei Bushkov. It is through an incredible amount of adversity that they have risen to the top of the skating world. Brent Musburger takes an up-close and personal look at the reigning world champions.
Over the last century, no country has been so ripped apart as Russia. Revolution, collapse, reform, economic despair. Some still fight for ideals they knew. Others have left for enticements west. But most here are lost, somewhere between holding on to a tormented past and embracing an uncertain future. Together now for 8 years, Marina Yeltsova and Andrei Bushkov, too, are stuck between a dissolved Soviet sports machine that created stars of the late 80s, like Gordieva and Grinkov, who went on to prosper financially in the States, and between the younger generation of Ilya Kulik and Irina Slutskaya, who have attracted offers to train in America and big-time agents. But Marina and Andrei have somehow fallen through the cracks.
When it was still the Soviet Union, I remember they would play the Soviet anthem and you had the feeling that you were part of something big and important. Then when all the republics became independent states, I had the feeling that something very dear to me had been lost.
I remember some time ago when somebody won and everyone would come to the airport and bring flowers and celebrate. Now when you come back from competition, you're greeted only by family. Something is gone.
They came together as their country was coming apart. They lost their financial support since the end of the Soviet Union. They received $45 a month from the Olympic Committee. Prize money is split 30% coach, 30% government, and 10% federation. The message from the country, the message from the federation was, give up.
We had to prove to ourselves and then to the people that it's too early for us to be written off. When you hear that from people, it's frightening. But we were able to show the world that we are still strong.
After making the world team in 1993, 94 should have been their Olympic opportunity. But with the return of professionals to eligible status and a lack of coaching support, their chance was taken away. Feeling unwanted and alone, Marina and Andrei decided to risk leaving their acclaimed coach, Igor Moskvin, coach of the legendary Protopopovs, for an unknown.
People said, why you change coach? Your coach is known all over the world, and the coach you're switching to is young, and nobody knows her. We asked ourselves, what is more important for us? The coach with a reputation who does not care about us, or an untitled one who will really work with us and for us?
Gold at the 1996 Worlds gave Yeltsova and Bushkov an identity for the first time, but it's one they must struggle to hold on to. Russia, too, tries to distinguish herself. Signs of change abound, yet with an average salary of $22 a week, most struggle to adapt. Marina and Andrei and their country grapple with uncertainty.
Perhaps our place is where we are, somewhere between, because we cannot join the younger generation, and we can't go back.
When you understand what they've been through and what they continue to endure, you have even more appreciation for what they've been able to accomplish, the reigning European and world champions in second place, like they were a year ago in Edmonton, Yeltsova and Bushkov of Russia.
The music, The Day When You Love Me.
This is the program that they performed last year at the World Championships. There's a solid and comfortable quality to this team. You find yourself not getting nervous for every element that they do.
We have to remember they are as the defending champions.
Well, they've got to let that mistake go and go on and concentrate and focus on all the rest of the tricks. Side by side, double axles, very well done. They do have wonderful flow over the ice.
I height that he lifts her to in this throw.
Nice tight rotations in the air.
Such a nice calm about them. There's no rushing or extraneous moves to their skating. It's very simple, but very effective. Deceptively difficult. This throw, triple, toe loop.
She is so compact in the air, rotating very quick.
Their chief rivals, Wurzel and Stoya, still to skate. In fact, they're up next.
Lovely dropout on that. Very crisp and fast and sharp and clean.
Among those that have skated, Kazakova and Dmitriev in the lead ahead of Ina and Dungeon.
Very pleasant number to watch.
Yes, easy on your eyes. It didn't have quite the tension or the impact or the power that we've seen on some of the other pairs, but very sort of gently pleasant.
And the fall early on, though, Dick, we'll see how that's reflected in the scores of Marina Yeltsova and Andrei Buzhkov of Russia. We'll have those marks when we return to Lausanne. And then it's the leaders after the short program, Mandy Wurzel and Ingo Stoya of Germany. Well, just like a year ago, Yeltsova and Buzhkov started the free skate in second place. In Edmonton, they won. We'll see if the judges think their performance was good enough to win here.
And here's a look at their side-by-side triple toe loops where Andrei fell on it. He was just way back on his skate, didn't finish the rotations to check out and flow out of that landing.
Well, the overall performance was, like they say about wine, a nice performance, not a great performance. And I think that certainly leaves the door open for the other skaters at the top of this competition.
You see the technical merit marks, Dick?
For judge number three from Canada, which is interesting, and also judge number eight from Great Britain.
Those marks good enough to put Yeltsova and Buzhkov in first place in terms of those that have skated already.
So on the ice, Mandy Wurzel, Ingo Stoya, Germany.
But here are Mandy Wurzel and Ingo Stoya of Germany. They have defeated Yeltsova and Buzhkov four times in international competitions this year. They've been in this spot before, too. They were the leaders a year ago. They'll try not to relinquish that spot this year in Lausanne.
The music, In Memory, by Danny Wright.
I think besides being a very handsome couple on the ice, they finally found consistency and confidence in this past season.
Well, these side-by-side triple toes will tell much of the story. A slightly corkscrewed one, but they were done, and they were full, and they'll get all the credit they need.
And watch the spring that she gets from this split triple twist. Good split.
Go. They're not. This is not the perfect night for these pairs.
Every one of the top pairs teams so far
made a major mistake.
Absolutely.
Double
two-footed.
Foot.
Yes.
I think they are bit by bit destroying their chances.
Remember, they were the leaders, though, after the short program.
Beautiful position in the air. Put together.
The parallel landing was even nicer. Mm-hmm. The unison here is first rate. One of the things that they do have going for them is that they're very strong, clean skaters. They're unpretentious, straightforward.
I think this music is very difficult for skating because it's so soft and quiet, but I think that they really bring a lot of its highs and lows out very well.
Mentioned the four wins they enjoyed over Yeltsov and Buzhkov this year, the only major event in which they did not accomplish that, the European Championships in Paris.
Pair split jump, half loop, double toe.
Eradicate some of the previous mistakes. This is really turning out to be an interesting pair competition. A wonderful performance, but again, mistakes.
And it is wide open right now. Yeltsov and Buzhkov in first. We'll see if Vuksel and Stoya can overtake them. And Jenny Mino and Todd Sand on the ice next. You want to win a world championship? It's there for them. See if they can take it.
Babylonia and Randy Gardner did the impossible.
This could be a little sporting history.
They broke the Soviet Union's 14-year reign, becoming the first Americans to win a World Pairs title since 1950. No U.S. team has won the championship since.
Isn't that a great scene? Isn't that beautiful?
Back in Lausanne, the pairs free skate continuing, and Mandy Wurzel and Ingo Stori awaiting their marks.
And look at these side-by-side jumps. Watch her. This is the problem. Good unison to that point, and then she starts leaning out of the circle, and of course the jump goes.
Not pleased as they look up at the scoreboard and see their technical merit marks.
Well, you see that the interesting point is that the marks are so close with the other skaters that any upset coming on can screw up the entire list.
The presentation marks, and they are good enough, though, Dick, for Wurzel and Stoyer to get to the top over Yeltsova and Bushkov. But remember, that can still change with remaining skaters on the ice. And perhaps the opportunity has never been better for Jenny Mino and Todd Sand to capture a world championship. They have been the bronze medalist, 95, 96, silver medalist at the U.S. Championships this year. But with all the mistakes that we have seen, the door is wide open for them now.
The music, Rachmaninoff's Concerto No. 2, the third movement.
Well, even though they had a solid short program, their confidence has been shaken in this past month. And their toughest obstacle is this first move coming up, side by side, triple toe loops.
Now she tripled it, but he only doubled. That's been a problem area for him. Even in the practice session, he wasn't able to achieve one.
This is a triple salchow. Oh, she wanted to hold on to that landing.
Split, triple twist. Oh, that was like a 2.5 move, and she landed going forward. Side by side double axles. Single axle into double toe loops.
One thing that has held Todd back is his back. He's had problems with that. And throughout the week here, we've seen him taking care of it and also not overexerting himself during practice on the ice.
They've had very shaky practices all week long. Cluttered choreography, very reserved, steady, and in control. Beautiful positions.
Jenny and Todd trying to accomplish something that has been very rare. Only two couples in the U.S. have won a world medal without being the national champions. The last time it took place was in 1949. They were in fourth after the short. Now, Wurzel and Stoyer lead Yeltsova and Bushkov, and then Kazakova and Dmitriev, your top three, in Dungeon in fourth.
this throw, double axe throw.
Well, if you looked at it closely, you saw a very weak landing.
Yes.
Very weak landing edge. Right there.
Very elegant position in the air. Final move forward inside death spiral.
Look at the beautiful arch that she has descending into that death spiral.
And he took that very carefully because at the Nationals he lost his edge. Very unfortunate.
Well, that was a pro. What can you say about these programs? They're all entertaining, they're all pleasant, and they all have mistakes.
Well, the American fans here say they liked it, but only the judges' opinions count. Jenny Mino and Todd Sand in fourth trying to move up with that free skate. And the last pair's team to skate will take the ice next. Yelena Beresnaya and Anton Tsikhorodlyja of Russia. Anxious moments that must seem like they take a lifetime for Jenny Mino and Todd Sand and their coach John Nix awaiting their scores.
And here's a look at that split triple twist that you don't see a mistake on this very often in a pair team. She didn't complete the revolution. She should have landed backwards. Instead, she landed forward. Very unusual mistake.
And that was very damaging to them. When they took the ice, a very real possibility that they could medal or win. The technical merit marks ticked there very low.
And the artistic impression, not great either.
Mino and Sand now in fifth place. And here are Yelena Beresnaya and Anton Tsikhorodlyja in their first year together. They have a chance to win a world championship, but that's only a small part of their story. Here's Brent Musburger with an up-close and personal look at a very courageous young woman.
All I remember is we were skating and spinning when I felt this unexplainable blow to my head. I kept spinning and I felt like I was falling, and then suddenly I felt something dripping. All of a sudden, people were all around me. I tried to speak, but I couldn't. The ambulance came and took me to the hospital. I don't remember feeling pain. The doctor asked me questions, but I couldn't answer. What my name was, where I lived. They said, say something, but I couldn't. They told me I needed surgery, so I nodded to show I understood.
The blade had shattered bone fragments inside Yelena's skull. Doctors performed two brain operations.
When I woke up from the surgery, I was in a fog. Everything ached. It took 3 days before I started to speak again. Oleg was supportive at first. He said we would train and still make it for world championships, but the doctors told me otherwise.
First, doctors thought Yelena would be in bed for 3 weeks. Then they thought 6 months.
I was in shock. I couldn't believe I wasn't allowed to do anything. I cried. I just wanted to go home.
Yelena improved quicker than doctors expected. A month later, she went home, but decided to no longer skate with Oleg. After 3 months of physical and speech rehabilitation, Yelena went back to the ice with her new partner, Anton Tsikhorodlyja. But some might wonder how she could feel safe at all. Why go back to the ice, to the danger?
I wanted to go back to skate. I wanted to go back to all my friends who had supported me. To tell you the truth, I don't know what I'd do if I couldn't skate.
I like was a little bit of her mother, for her. Then I thought, oh, if it will be my daughter, how will I behave? Because I was afraid. I didn't know how her body will react after she recovered and while she was recovering.
Before, I never thought about such things as dropping my partner or falling. Now I have to be extremely careful with her and give her much more attention, because any fall can have severe consequences.
I think the people around me were more scared than I was. For me, it felt as simple as relearning to walk.
She slowly started to walk on ice, do little steps. After a while, like maybe half a month, then she decided to jump her double, triple. I was like surprised and astonished. And even when they started to do that dreadful element side by side, camel spin with a new partner, I told them, please stay away from each other, stay far. But she didn't show any fear.
But there are still lingering effects.
I still have difficulty speaking. I can remember the words, but when I speak, there's a trace of an accent. So Russian people think I sound like an American and say hello.
Yelena has progressed rapidly, off and on the ice. The pair amazed all at the Europeans, where they placed third. Yelena has found strength in herself and in Anton.
I know that those people who had in their lives so much difficulties, and they showed their will to continue to do what they like, they will achieve sooner or later.
It is amazing that they are even here on the ice, but they have a very real chance of winning a world championship.
Well, they are the most exciting thing about this couple is their mix of superb unison and very gentle power, and they have enormous potential.
Don't even bother looking at that until they get through this move here, which they didn't.
He had trouble on the warm-up with his triple jump.
Now coming up, a split twist lift. The others all do triples, this couple only a double, but look at the height that they get. The air is just wonderful there. So difficult for them. Again, he's down. Now, but
I think he swings his free leg kind of wide around, and he doesn't have that tight rotation in the air.
Well, it hasn't been easy so far in this free skate, but remember, they were in third place heading into this portion of the competition. And if you're in the top three and win the free skate, you are the overall winners.
He has such exceptional stretch and line for a male skater, very reminiscent of Sergei Grinkov.
And she, equally reminiscent of Ekaterina Gordieva.
Yes.
Now they need the same strength, power, and technical ability. Well, you know, what do you say?
It's a very rough night for the pairs. Everyone has made some mistakes.
But one of the things to look at is the line that the two of them have. They present a very light, classical line and style.
And it's so unusual for a pair to be equally, you know, good in both the power and that beautiful body line that they have.
And obviously their relationship away from the ice, very important, and Anton's support of Yelena through this whole ordeal, coming back from that tragic injury.
You know, there's something very interesting happening with the marking in this competition. If you note, right so far, Kazakova and Dmitriev are way down in the ordinals, even though they are in third place, and right behind them are Ina Dungeon, very close. With this kind of a mess up here, we could see some very strange
shifting of the positions at the end of this pair.
Well, Dick, as we saw at the European Men's Championship this year, when there is no clear-cut winner of the free skate, you can see a lot of shuffling in the leaderboard after that portion of the competition.
Really off on their unison.
What a sad moment. What a sad moment. I mean, a year of build-up to this, and you have one five-minute, four-minute chance, and it's a not a happy one.
Yeah. That's skating, isn't it?
Yep.
The perseverance has gotten them to this point. It will get them through this as well. Yelena Bereznaya and Anton Tsikhanouskaya of Russia.
The World Figure Skating Championships, presented by MasterCard. This special edition of ABC's Wide World of Sport.
He can't bear to watch the marks coming up. Yelena Bereznaya alongside her coach tomorrow, Muscovina.
But look at these marks. I mean, that dropped them. That has dropped them so far down. They are at least in eighth or ninth place.
And remember, they can change these marks. They can change the leaderboard ahead of Bereznaya and Tsikhanouskaya. The presentation marks very low as well. 4.4. Up to 5.4 for this courageous Russian pairs team. However, at the top, there is no change. Mandy Futsal celebrating. She has just found out that she and Ingo Stoya, for the first time in their careers, are world champions.
And this will be a moment they won't forget. But the interesting point is that at the top, the point system for the ordinal placements was so widespread, it means that the judges simply could not agree across the board on where they thought the top three should be.
And they become the first team to wear gold and represent a unified Germany since 1939.
Maxi Herber and Ernst Beyer.
There you go. Yeltsin Buzhkov captures silver. Artur Dmitriev goes back to the world podium with Oksana Kazakova. Solid finishes for the American teams. Heartbreak for Bereznaya and Tsikhanouskaya, but they've inspired a lot of people this week.
Coming up next, the men's competition with last year's world champion, Todd Eldridge, Russia's rising star, Ilya Kulik, the powerful Canadian former world champion, Elvis Stoyko, and the leader, Olympic champion, Alexei Ermanov. When we return to Lausanne, Switzerland, and the World Figure Skating Championships, presented by MasterCard.